I'm Just Women Talk Show, another exciting episode in the Marital Storm series. So guys, sit back. I'm here with this interesting couple. They're here to share with us their life experiences with regards to waiting on God for the fruit of the womb. So our topic is waiting on God for the fruit of the womb. This topic is very sensitive, but I believe that so many out there, so many couples trusting God for the fruit of the womb would really be blessed and inspired. So sit back, grab whatever you got. Remember to subscribe to this channel so you will keep, we'll keep you updated of, you know, subsequent notifications of other, you know, episodes coming soon. So let's introduce our guest. Please, Daddy and Mommy, please can introduce yourself to the viewers. I'm sure they would like to know you guys.
Okay. Thank you so much, Mom. My name is Olusegun Olagunju, and my wife sitting next to me is going to introduce herself.
My name is Anulu Akko Olagunju.
Okay, nice to meet
you.
Thanks for giving us the audience and the opportunity to, you know, share with us, you know, your experience and then your contribution on Mom and Jesus. So guys, as I said, please sit back. Remember to subscribe if you haven't subscribed. You know, this will keep you in note of other, you know, episodes. So Daddy and Mommy, welcome once again to Mom and Jesus. So let's see.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. We want to address this issue, waiting on God, trusting God for the fruit of the womb. We understand that so many couples, you know, some married for over 10, 5, 6, 15, even 20, are still trusting God for the fruit of the womb. And I believe that with the little experience I know of my sister, one or two people watching would really be blessed. So we'll start by asking, what are the major causes of, you know, this delay when you get married? Expectation is after 1 year, 2 years, even people will start asking questions. My sister, my brother, what is happening? Especially the women, you know, they usually blame the women for, you know, most likely what is going on and all that. So what do you think are the causes, you know, of this delay of waiting on a child in marriage?
Okay, all right. It's a big question, really, because there's no tangible cause that I can say it. Maybe it's those in the medical practitioner that can tell you the biological factor of having children, this one, that. But biblically, the Bible says children are heritage of God and they are God's gifts.
True.
And then delay, causes of delay in conception can vary. It can be medical, it can just be you are fine and then you are not giving birth. There are some couples like that, they are waiting, they've done all the medical checkup. They just don't know that they can conceive. Prior to my husband and I were just having a reflection, and it was like, okay, maybe nature can cause it, the environment, maybe we need to change the environment. And then sometimes you are tense up, it might not always be medical aspect is
changed. It's good to check up.
But, yeah, it's good to do your medical checkup too. But basically, it goes like it's children.
True.
So the causes, yeah, I've seen people that get married in their 30s, 40s, and they conceive immediately. And I've seen people in the state of 20s that are still waiting on God for the fruit of the womb.
Absolutely.
So it's not, some people will say age, some people will say slow sperm count. Yeah, those things matter, but sometimes it comes to these children are God gift.
True.
Thank you so much for that thing. Daddy?
Well, just to add to what she has said, I would want to look at it in the aspect of the factors could be from the guy's side or the lady's side. And I always want to look at it like it could be 33% chance from the male side, 33% chance from the female side, also even 33% from God, and 1% from nature. Yes, from the male side, it could be as a result of medical that she has said, and it could actually be from God. We've seen
test of faith.
Yes, instances even in the Bible where it was even written that God shut this particular person's womb. So it could be from God, and also nature as well. It could be that the environment that you are in at the moment doesn't actually give that possibility for conception. So all of this could become matter, and then we need to not just to focus on one side. We have to actually holistically look at
all the areas. Thank you so much, sir, for that insight. Wow, viewers, Daddy and Mommy has given us an insightful take on that. I've never heard where environment was actually considered a factor, so this is quite insightful for me. I thank you so much. Okay, moving on to the next question. I want to know the impact, because we know the societal pressure, you know, the social-cultural impact or effect, and also the psychological effect it will have on couples when they wait for 2-3 years and, you know, conception is not happening. What are the likely things, impacts or whatever, what are the likely things that couples face? Mama, let's start with you.
The social, you know, in African context, that we are generally, so the people that wants to marry, they need to tell you already in 9 months' time, they're coming to you.
So it's expected.
The expectation, regardless of the fact that maybe you and your husband are settled, we are going to wait the next 1 year, 2 years before we start conceiving or before we start having children. So sometimes culture, the social culture impact, it's very much. It affects you as a couple. I'm speaking from experience. One thing, I will say all this, my experience, and then I'll wrap it up by saying that just trust God and know God. I know it's easier said than done, because I've been there and I understand and it felt. Sometimes in church, people, I've had experience whereby one or two things have been said, even in the setting, Christian setting, that shook your faith, like, you don't expect people to say this kind of thing, you understand. Even when you are strong for yourself, you know, people, other people, what they say sometimes will want to shake your faith and all the rest. So there are a lot of social cultural impacts on expecting children, people who look at you, age is growing. I remember there was one time somebody, a person called me close to the family and saying, what's your mommy doing? What's your mother doing?
Oh my God.
You not having children. I was like, so, you know, even when you are trying to be strong for yourself, all those comments, what I used to overcome it when I was with this. I didn't channel all my energy towards looking for children, you know. I divert into something else, focus on my studies.
Right.
So it's not just what is preoccupying me only. Children. So I have other things, goals that why I'm lucrating for children, so let me pursue
other things.
That's one of those things that helped me then when I was waiting. Because you can lose your mind because of comments, whether directly or indirectly, whether knowingly or unknowingly. You understand? There are some people that comment, they don't know the impact or how hot. You know, because sometimes when you've not been through a situation before, you might not know how it feels. So, those are one of two things that I did then that helped me to overcome those sociocultural expectation.
Thank you so much, Daddy.
Well, I think she has actually said most of it. What I would say is that, yes, those sociocultural influence will come. But one thing that is very, very important for the couples themselves is for them to be able to hold their hands together, hold themselves together during those periods.
Right.
Because they always say that if you don't allow the influence of the outside influence to have impact on your on your inside. So if we don't, they will come, not even from church or from friends or what, even your families, they will throw it. I remember most of the time when I was even talking to my own mother, herself, was saying, what is happening? I said, God will do it. God will do it. Well, and then we keep praying. So number one thing is for the couples waiting, for not to allow those influence to affect them negatively, right? Yes, those words might come. It's also as a result of what they're expecting, right? So, but the couples must be able to hold themselves together, no matter how. Yes, someone might say, oh, you are just saying it because I know exactly how it feels. You don't allow that to affect your inside. Because you know that for sure, God will do it at his own time.
Wow, so thank you, sir, for that. Okay, let's just find out. I would like to know, I'm sure viewers will also like to know, how were you both able to support each other? Because in some cases, either the man or the woman, especially the man, the woman, you know, she is more, being that we're more emotional, she will need more support from her partner. So, how were people able to support each other? I'm sure some couples will learn from that.
Okay, one of the things about waiting on God is the Bible says two are better than one because they have great results for their labor. There are times I am down. That's why I said when one is down,
the other is
lifting up. True. There are experiences, situations like that when we're waiting, when I am the one down, and then he's the one giving the word of encouragement to happen. And there are some situations where he's the one, I'm the one giving the encouragement. Unity is important. You understand?
Right.
Unity is important. The same front, saying the same thing is important to everybody. Saying the same thing to everybody. And then, what if you have a medical condition? Just look between yourself, and maybe if you have a prayer partner. But when we were looking for the fruit of the waiting, we never said even a pastor.
Wow.
I said, please, pastor, pray
for
us.
Wow, wow.
It's just whatever. Sometimes you say, oh, I'm convinced that we should give this person some certain things to sow a seed. It's just between nobody told us that we'll do it. So we never went to a pastor because we're like, okay, the Bible is there. We've seen examples of people waiting. For and there's a service in our church, Covenant Day of Fruitfulness, that we always observe almost monthly or so. So we key into all those things, and we never really go out for once to say pray for us. Or I've never even been. There was even instances whereby I was invited to a certain program in the church, but I was not coming. I was like, okay, God is not is everywhere, so I can buy like from one program to another. It's good to go to all those programs, but for yourself, have that conviction that he has promised
who's doing it.
So togetherness as a husband, if your husband bring an idea and say, babe, let's do this thing, even if you are not convinced about it, just do it. So the unity is important. I'm sure my husband will
to answer that. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Yes, I think she has said most of it. During those periods, it will come. Your faith will also be shaken. But one thing is for you to have that conviction that surely God has said this. You know, if we are looking at how we have examples of this in the Bible, where people have looked unto God for children, and so we have a consolation where it is written in the Bible, and that way we need to
hold on.
Because you know, it was just like, look at the case of Abraham. Abraham, I mean, he was he actually challenged God to say, oh, all these things that you are actually giving me. So it's even the slave that you've given me that will inherit. But God told him, no, I'm still going to do it. Mm. And that word is very, very important. So we need to hold on. Yes, it might be like, oh, it's easier said than done. But it is very, very, it's what you actually do during those periods that is very, very important. Mm. Hold on. Yes, you can say it's easier said than done. You have to do it because someone who had done it has a result. Mm. And if you really want to have the same result as that, you also need to do the same. Mm. Okay, so holding on to God's word is very, very important during the period of waiting. Mm. And you might not even know that God might actually be preparing you for someone that will actually inspire someone as well. So what you do in those periods really, really matters.
Mm.
Because God will do it, for sure. God will do it. But what do you just want to go through it in a situation whereby you are depressed all the time? Depression, it will not bring the solution.
Mm.
You know, depression or anxiety will even complicate the matter, because when you are dating, anxiety and all of that has impact too
on the
hormones and all of that. So the body has to be in place, faith has to be in place, and then we leave the remaining part to God to do, and God will surely do it.
Thank you so much, viewers, so much take home. You know, trusting God, anchoring your faith on God, regardless of how, you know, the psychological. Like, I remember when I lost. I had two miscarriages in the same year. I was so frustrated, like, you know, but I just said, no, I'm going to take my mind off it's trying to conceive. Because I was calculating, they're doing the right thing, and it just kept going. And not until I threw my focus on my master's program, it just happened on its own. So I believe that sometimes God just wants us to, you know, just surrender, let go, let God do his thing. So for viewers watching, I do believe that you've been encouraged so far. So please, I just also want us to shed more light, being that you have had this experience. And people that have had children, sometimes I know they make comments, side comments, and, you know, they pass statements that probably they might not have the intention of hurting a couple or someone trusting God. Do you have anything to say to such? Because I believe that we should also address that angle. You know, the angle of people having empathy, or I'm not saying pity, but just try to be sensitive, probably when discussing with someone trusting or waiting on God. You know, do you have any advice for them before we give advice for those trusting God for the fruit of the womb?
Okay, you understand that people are different. What I say to, maybe what you say to my husband, my husband might feel like, why would she say this? And me, I'm like, okay, it's fine, there's nothing,
you don't feel anything
what you say. But when people are going through a certain situation, loss or any loss, I think people should just be careful what they say. You understand?
True.
Because there is a lot of things out there. Depression, my husband has been mentioned with depression, you don't know what people are going through at a particular time. So we need to be careful with our words. Anytime I wake up in the morning, I always ask God, give me the tongue of the maid. Give me the tongue of the maid, you know, to know how to say the right thing at the right time, to the right person. It's very, very,
very important.
Crucial in this world that we live in, because a word can change a destiny, and a word can mar a destiny. So it depends on you as a person. Ask for the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit will always tell you the right thing. Either somebody waiting for conception, waiting for spouse, waiting on them, believing. Because we are all believing God for one thing or the other. It's just that children is more pronounced. People expect to see children. But there are so many people that are waiting on God, and they are passing through this phase of their life. So, and sometimes they're just depressed, and then you come and say one thing. Oh, normally they will just take it, they will laugh about that. But because they are going through one thing that morning, that moment, they feel offended that you said this particular thing. So, people can just ask, if you're a Christian, ask for the tongue of the man. You know what to say at the right time. You know, because you might say thing now, it is okay, but it's not the right time.
that you say such.
Yes.
Wow, thank you so much for that. Thank you, my sister. Do you have anything to add?
Well, it's just to portray what you have said.
Mm.
It has to be, you have to be cautious of what you see around people, you know. Right words, there is a way by which the Bible says it, that right word, you have to be able to author right words, you know, because you don't know the words are like seed, let me put it that way. And then the way you say something might be taken, might be misinterpreted. So your words should always be put in a way by which it doesn't damage the morale or the receiver. So let's exercise caution as to what we see around people, because we don't really know what they are going through at the moment.
If I might add to what give an explicit scenario. So we're in church one day, it's covenant day of fruitfulness, like the church we attend. So it's a day for people waiting on the fruit of you. So I was praying, and then one day it came to me, pray at that to Adam, like as you pray. I was like, I don't understand that I'm waiting for. So many people feel as if waiting on for God for children is the biggest test you will ever go through in life. So I was like, okay, why not focus on your own year of fruitfulness? I didn't say it, you know, but I was like, okay, you feel that
should be offended about
you. Why not you focus? There are some areas of your life that you need fruitfulness. So we are not talking about fruitfulness of the body. So the person might feel that is just, if you want to, like I said to people, if you are not so close to people, very, very close, and people are waiting, expecting God, don't just come
even
and
see. Even if you are close, do you think it's even...
You will see, when the person is pregnant, you will know that this person, essentially, you know, some people will come and tell you, is he put your tummy in, like, if you are not so close, that person has not opened up to you. There's a friend of mine that was waiting on God. We're so close in school. So there was a day we went to, she was doing her master's. So I went to my former school, that was when I was still in Nigeria, to get my transcript. I was processing my own admission to South Africa. Okay. So she now called me, she said, Anu, for the past 5 years, you never even bothered to ask me about my conception. You know, I've not given birth. So I said, I'm praying for you. In my heart, that home. So I know that you are going through one thing or the other. Holy Spirit to tell me people that are praying for me. I know in church people, they don't come to me, but I know this way. The Spirit will just connect. I know that this person is. They don't need to come and tell me, I'm praying for you, sister. By next 9 months, you must. You don't need to come and
voice it out.
The Spirit, I know people that do not come to me to tell me that. They are praying for me, but my spirit tells me that this person was praying for me when I was with him. So all those and those people, some people are doing it for show me. So I'm praying for you. It's good if you are really close to that person, as in very, 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 very close. But when you are just sisters in church, in unity,
mindful
of how what you say and all the rest.
Thank you so much. I can relate to that situation when I had after the miscarriages. A lady approached me and said, you are not praying enough. I didn't forget that statement. I didn't forget that statement because it felt like, God, does that mean her prayer? Are you quantifying her prayer more than, is she in my secret closet to know how much I pray? So that was why I had to ask this question, because I know there are so many side comments and, you know, that really gets at couples and are still trusting of God. Okay, so thank you for your takes. I also like us to wrap up by asking if you have any advice for any couples still trusting and waiting on God for the fruit of the womb. The advices you have for
Well, the advice that I will give is, number one is trust in God. Because he's the one that can do it. Okay. Secondly, is also that we also need to stay positive. You know, we should know all of these things to us to do with psychology as well.
True.
Psychology plays a very big role in this. So we have to be positive. You can't be saying, oh, I'm believing God for the fruit of the womb, and yet you keep, you are always down, you are always sad, you are, no, we need to always be up here. We need to be positive minded. We need, our emotion has to be in place.
Mm.
Another thing is that we need to go for checkups as well.
Okay, very, very true.
Yeah, the male, you know, you don't know exactly where this might actually be. Yes. So at least you do your part, right?
Mm.
Do your checkups. I did, during our period of waiting as well, we had to go for those checks. And then, yes, it was certified that, okay, everything is fine. Then you know exactly where you are channeling your prayers to.
Mm.
So it's very, very important. And lastly, you need to wait. You need to, I mean, be hopeful that it will happen.
Mm-hmm.
And surely it will happen.
Mm. Thank you, sir.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. You are sure you're blessed. Mama, any take home?
Okay. When you are waiting, if you are a Christian, serve in your church. When you see people conceiving, giving birth to babies in your church, celebrate with them, rejoice with them. Show a token of love. Not necessary. If you don't have to sow a seed or give, be there, like be around them, and talk positively. I remember a situation, and I don't know, maybe I'm talking too much now.
No, please be open.
A lady gave birth, so we went to pay a visit. So they were talking like, okay, this is what is expected when you give birth, you tie this thing. So I was like, oh, me, I'm going to tie when I give birth, I'm going to tie because I don't want my tummy to be out or something like that. So when we got to, my husband was not saying, the way I'm even talking, I'm not even talking as if I'm waiting. I'm talking as if the child is already, like, I'm just about to
so
give birth.
So positive.
And like,
I love
so
that.
So I didn't see it as if I will not have a child. I see like it's a matter of time. And another thing is that focus your energy on some. Don't focus on, like I said, on just, I want to, you will be depressed. Like, find something else that gives you joy, happiness. Be productive. Like, I'll celebrate little, because if you are productive, you celebrate little means like, okay, I'm able to submit my proposal to deliver, and I accept it.
About that one.
So focus on something else that make you
so many
happy,
other things
yeah,
make you
in the process.
Mm. Wow, I'm blown away. Viewers, please drop your take homes and help me thank our wonderful guests. They've done justice to this topic. Thank you so much once again. I believe that for every couple waiting, the Lord will do it. Trust God with all what the advices they're giving. Trust God. Do the right checkups that needs to be done. And